ウィリアムさんと呼んでたんですけど、
I have to tell you that、I was not meant to be in the movie、that is a last minute thing because my actor、couldn't show up so I had to learn the lines the night before
なんとですね、今驚きました。ウィリアムさんと呼びかけてみたんですが、実はあの役ね、僕が演じる予定ではなかったんです。別の俳優がちゃんといたんですけれども、急に前日に来れないということになって、いきなりセリフを全部覚えました。
So forgive my performance if it's not too good.
あまり良くない出来だったらごめんなさい。Well, so, Glenn, I might like to maybe mention that the, for the last 10 years you've been also busy with a, theater production and would like to... maybe mention this the Blue Mansion it's very theatrical type of film isn't it and I was just wondering if it's coming from your you know the theatrical background and how have your 10 years been and I'll speak that I mentioned that in Japanese そうですね、この映画ですね、非常にこう室内劇というか、とてもこう舞台っぽい映画だっていう風にちょっと感じた方もいらっしゃるかもしれないんですけれども、まあ、それは監督が非常にですね、演劇の方でとても活動が盛んな方で、ロンドンではM バタフライ、皆さん映画にもなった作品ではアンソニー・ホプキンスさんと一緒に演じていらっしゃったりっていう経験があるんですが、ちょっと演劇のお話とその映画のことをお伺いしたいと思います。そちらちょっと。
Yes, my life has constantly revolved around theater. I think my first recollection of directing theater was at the age of 11, so that's going back about 35 years.So it is inevitable that the work I do also reflects that background. Although I think my writer Ken Kwek and myself were very conscious that we were going to be doing a film which was very theatrical, and that was conscious. That was a conscious decision. and the reason being by doing it.In this sort of theatrical way, we also wanted to create this this layer of artifice to remind the audience that this is just a comedy, this is a piece of fiction. Sit back and enjoy yourself.
It's good for budget as well, isn't it? Because you want to go like this.
Yes.
ですね、私の人生で演劇というものはとてもですね、重要な位置を占めていて、11歳の時に演出を始めて、自分なりで始めて、もう35年、ずっと演劇に関わっています。そしてもちろん僕自身のですね、そういった演劇の背景を反映していると同時に、脚本を手掛けた、ケン・クエック、彼がですね、非常にこう演劇的なものを意識して、作った脚本を書いたということがありますね。つまりこう演劇っていうのはこう非常にこう人工的に作られたものであって、それはあくまでもコメディで現実とは違うものだということをかえって明らかにして、もう劇場に出たら現実との線引きをするというようなことなんですね。
I always find that there is I like doing comedies because I always find that there is actually a very thin line between comedy and tragedy. In fact, I always think that they're both different sides of the same coin.
でコメディがねとても好きな理由はっていうのは、本当に悲劇と悲劇って紙一重ですよね。だからコインの両面、そんな面を兼ね備えていると思います。 Now we'd like to ask Emma、So you've been So maybe you can tell us a little bit about how have you been working with Glenn and must have been very challenging and difficult role and it's the first time in the film. So would you like to share that with us?
Well, my background is in theatre. I've been working on the Singapore stage for more than 10 years now, and many of my productions have been with Glenn. So I think between us, there is a lot of trust, and also there is a lot of respect. I respect him as a director, and he respects me as an actress. So we don't... When he offered me this role, I was so excited because I've never done film before, and even though it was very difficult, I was not afraid because I will do whatever he wants me to do.
演劇にですね、確かにここ10年ぐらい演劇界で活動してきて、中でもその10年の中でグレーン監督がですね、こう演出をしたものが非常に多かったんですね。ですからもう信頼関係が出来上がっていて、非常に尊敬をしているので、もう映画に、ね、出てって言われた時はとても嬉しかったし、もう何をやれって言われても、もう何も心配せずに役を演じたということなんですね。 それでは皆様から何か、感想と質問を受けたいと思います。それでは挙手でお願いします。Please raise your hands for comments and questions. じゃあ一番先に挙げていただいた方で、その後こちら参ります。
はい、本当に楽しい映画でした。全然前知識がなかったんで、こんなに笑える映画だとは思わなかったんで、すごく楽しかったです。それで質問なんですけども、最後にエマさん演じる花嫁が血まみれになって、出てくるんですけども、あそこは回想シーンですよね。現在のシーンではなくて、倒れた時の過去の時に見た映像だということで出てきたと思ったんですけど、ちょっとそこが分からなかったんで、どっちかなと思って、でもしあそこが回想シーンだとすると、最後がエマさんの最後が回想シーンだとちょっと寂しいかなと思ったんで、できればラストシーンに奥さんと一緒に出てくるとかそういうのがあった方が楽しかったかなと思ったんで、ちょっとそこだけ知りたいなと。あとタイトルの青い館というのに何か意味があればと教えてください。
It was fun. It's an amusing film. I had no knowledge of the film prior to watching it, so I never thought that I get to laugh so much. Now, Mei Yi, she's towards the end, very end, she's covered in blood. And I thought it's not actually she turned into, you know, that turn into that from the, you know, wedding gown, but it's actually yes. From the past, the memory is recalling back, and she appeared the way she was when after she, you know, actually was committing suicide. So I just wanted to, if you could clarify that. And I wish Mei Yi would have come back together with the, you know, the mother, because I mean, it's a shame for Mei Yi the last scene we saw by her is covered with blood. So I'm just wondering whichever one.
The first part of the question.
As in, whether is she wearing a wedding dress, and why did she
wear that? She's covered in blood at the end, but that is not actually what father is seeing. It's hard to say reality, because it's not reality, but that's not real. Or is that the recollection of the father, or you turn into that?
Well, I think it's open to interpretation, but the way that I have always seen it is that it's this guilt about what he has done, about letting Mei Yi die, and he has suppressed this guilt for a long time, but it's coming up, and finally in that moment, in that climactic moment, suddenly it all comes back to him and he remembers what he did. So it's a figment of his imagination.
No, so I think you're right. It's not her turning from wedding dress to that situation. It's actually, according to the writer, in his imagination.
エマさんが言うには、いや、私の解釈ではやっぱりお父さんはずっと自分の罪の呵責をですね背負って生きてきて、もう押し殺しても抑えくれなくなって、もうあそこのこうクライマックスのシーンではもうそのお父さんの記憶で彼女を死なせてしまったという、あの記憶で想像が生み出した姿だと私は理解しています。ということで、グレン監督の方からは、そうですね、あれは私の考えでは花嫁の衣装からああいうふうに変わったのではなくて、お父さんがやはりそういうふうに見ているという。
Actually, can I answer the second part of this question? The reason why Mei Yi doesn't appear with the mother is because if you listen to the last speech of the father, he says, only the guilty are damned to live like this. In other words, to live as wandering spirits, looking for some peace. But she has actually found peace.
でなぜね、彼女がこうお母さんがね、復活して復活というか幽霊のように出てきてくれなかったのかなっていうのの答えは、お父さんが実はセリフで言っているんですね。やっぱり罪の意識があるものだけが浮かばれずにこういうふうに徘徊するんだと。ですから私の考えではメイイは自分の、気持ちの折り合いをつけて、今では平和を得ているからではないかなというふうに思います。And actually, the gentleman had another question, andThe Blue Mansion, now where did the title come from? I don't know, it's okay for us to sit down actually.
Okay. The name The Blue Mansion came after we made the film. The film was shot in a UNESCO architectural Conservation Award winner in Penang, which is also a World Heritage Site, UNESCO World Heritage Site.